What happened in Rwanda? Rwanda, actually, they did unveil their own phone that is manufactured in the country, and they called it the first African phone. And that was quite impressive. Apart from it being impressive, it was raising a lot of questions in regards to the rest of the East African region, the whole of Africa. What are we doing? Rwanda seems to be setting the pace. And today, Moi University, they came out and said, you know what? We've been working on something, and we are unveiling the first locally assembled laptop in the country. So you can buy a Kenyan assembled laptop in the country. Right now, in this particular discussion on matters innovation and higher learning, I'm joined by Professor Justice Wamukoya, who is the Dean, School of Information Sciences at Moi University. Thank you very much, sir, for speaking to business today. The first question is matters to do with innovation, sir, because today's unveil of this particular laptop, it shows that we have potential. But in our higher learning institutions, is innovation something that generally we are geared towards and focused our minds towards, making sure that our students and staff equally are innovative and are going towards that particular direction?
Thank you, Noah, for inviting us to KTN Studios to talk about what is happening at Moi University. As you rightly said, I'm the Dean of the School of Information Sciences, but I'm also the technical manager of Moi University Technologies. As you know, Moi University is a university of choice in building talent and innovation in science, technology, and development. And so in 2015, desirous of leaving that particular brand, we entered into an MOU with a Portuguese company that has been in the business of producing and supplying digital technologies in Portugal initially, and then in so many other countries that have done that in about 70, about 70 countries. We entered into an MOU for them to help Moi University build capacity in digital technologies, also in undertaking research and development, and then, of course, also building capacity in technical skills, particularly in ICT.
Yes.
And this is where our journey started.
Definitely. I'm glad, if I may just cut you, Professor Short, because I'm pretty sure you've been in the academia for quite a while. And overall speaking, when it comes to Kenyan universities, there's this complaint, even in the job market, there is a skill gap between what is happening in the university and what is required on the ground. As young people will say, you know, ground vitu ni different sometimes. But Professor, this issue of innovation, not even just, you know, Moi University as you've put your partnership, overall speaking, when it comes to our higher learning institutions, is it something that we're intentional?
I think different universities are different, doing different things. Certainly, I'm sure each university is engaged in some kind of innovation. Perhaps the difference might be the level at which we are doing it. Also, maybe we're not doing enough, but universities are very quickly waking up to this reality that this is the way to go. And that I think if universities don't do this, you know, then of course they are in a great danger of, you know, lagging behind, you know, the rest of the world. And it's on this particular platform that Moi University is riding, and I'm also aware that Jomo Kenyatta University have also been doing something in this area, and I'm sure many other Kenyan universities are doing it. However, I think us as Moi University, we are very focused on this now. We are very desirous to link up with industry and work together with industry, both within this country and from outside, to ensure that we are able to see technology transfer so that we can then also be able to pass on this necessary experience to our students.
Definitely.
And, you know, if you look at what we are doing at Moi University, this, we have more or less created a lab for students who are taking different courses. For instance, those who are taking information science courses, those who are doing computer science courses, those who are undertaking engineering courses, and many others also, giving a chance to all other students to be able to gain some skills over and above what they do in class.
Definitely.
And so we are, you know, we have actually climbed down from, you know, the ivory tower, and we are now doing what is needed, you know, to not only provide knowledge, but also to build up the skills capacity so that our students can be able to fit into, you know, the job market.
Definitely. To be specific about this particular innovation, the first locally assembled laptop.
Right.
As Mo University, you've worked with, you know, the census team,
the
very instrumental in that. For this particular product, the laptop.
Yes.
Oftentimes, just briefly, in the interest of time, the competitiveness of our products.
Yes.
There is the element of it being Kenyan, which is a good thing.
Right.
But at the same time, the people are looking at the value they're going to get.
Mm.
They're going to compare prices. What have you done to make it competitive, your product?
Yes. I think, I think like the president has always said, you know, I think we need to buy Kenyan products and to be able to build this economy. And of course, under the Big Four agenda, which is the president's, you know, pet subject, we have also tried to fit into the area of manufacturing. And this is where we come in with this innovation. And yes, there will be some skepticism about perhaps local products, but I can assure you, our products are very competitive. They have been built, you know, to the highest international standards. We are very careful that whatever we produce on our assembly lines, both in terms of raw materials and also in terms of the processes that these devices go through, they are able to meet, you know, the specifications at any particular moment. We did the school laptops project, and that was a learning curve. We actually managed, you know, to learn a lot on what we need to do in terms of standards. Mm-hmm. But we then moved on to undertake the Kenya National Bureau of Statistics National Census projects. And we manufactured devices which many of you may have interacted with during the census. I don't think there were many complaints or any complaints at all about these devices.
Yes.
And so, you know, our assembly line has got, you know, quality assurance built in at every stage of production.
Definitely.
And we make sure that, you know, this is complied with.
Definitely, sir.
Yeah, thank you.
And right now we want to take a look at this particular unveil where it is Matters Technology, and today the first locally assembled laptop in Kenya was unveiled. This is, of course, going par with Rwanda's unveil of their, you know, manufactured phone. East Africa is growing at large. Let's take a look at this.
Kenya has the skill and the capacity to build local technology that can compete on a global, you know, scope or stage.
If taxpayers paying taxes to grow Kenya, to bring in the industry, to contribute into the equation, into the ecosystem, to manufacture locally with policies to defending that the local industry can grow. So, and then at that time, bring in the right price, the best price competitive.
We would want to come up with policies that encourages even government to consume this kind of product, but again also taking into considerations that this is an open market. But then we always, because we also don't want to kill every other industry, but I think there is also emphasis on ensuring that actually our local